India is now the world's fifth largest economy. It's the world's fastest growing large economy. It's the world's most populous nation under Narendra Modi.
If you looked at the last estimates we put out in July for India's growth, then you'd get around there to 2027, 28. I think that's when you'd get to the third largest.
One thing that India has that's pretty fantastic is you have a great digital network, and you have a very high percentage of people using smartphones.
But the 21st century is going to be the Indian century.
Yes, this is indeed India's century, under the visionary leadership of a leader who gave hope, inspired people to dream, and promised to turn their dreams into reality. After independence, for the first time, we are living in a time where clean water at home is no longer a luxury, but a necessity. Gas connections aren't a privilege, but a right for every sister. Bank accounts are no more for the elite, but for every citizen. Home is not just bricks and stones, but is seen as a ground where the aspirations take place. In this video, we will talk about New India's journey in the last 9 years. The journey of survival, where New India met its basic necessities for the first time ever. Aspiration, when people were aspired to chase their dreams with grit. And inspiration, when New India's achievements inspired the world. Indeed, India has come a long way from survival mode to inspirational mode. But how? Gone are the days when colonial mindset unconsciously influenced our thinking. New India is now rejuvenating its ancient civilization and shedding its colonial mindset. India underwent survival mode initially with strategic initiatives like Swadesh Darshan, Hriday Yojana, and ambitious projects such as Kashi Vishwanath Dham, Kedarnath Dham, Mahakal Corridor, rejuvenating India's rich heritage. Transitioning into the aspirational phase, India shedded its colonial mindset by unveiling the Netaji statue at Kartavya Path. The installation of a new navy ensign inspired by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Renaming of 21 Andaman Islands after Paramveer Chakra awardees. And the national education policy emphasizing the promotion of learning in mother tongue. Today, India has steered for global recognition to millets, with the UN declaring 2023 as International Year of Millets. Today, the world celebrates yoga. Also, a remarkable 332% surge in khadi sales signifies a resurgence of traditional craftsmanship. Gone are the days when India waited for years to procure vaccines. New India not only manufactures vaccines but also exports to the world. India underwent survival mode initially with the creation of over 26 crore Ayushman cards, resulting in savings of 1 lakh crore in out-of-pocket expenses. India indigenously developed Made in India COVID vaccines and showcased its resilience in the face of health crisis. Transitioning into the aspirational phase, India's PPE industry witnessed a staggering 56 times growth in just 60 days. Not only this, India underwent ahead exporting vaccines to over 150 nations through the Vaccine Maitri initiative. Today, India has emerged as a global leader in vaccine supply, meeting 60% of the world's demand. India also runs the world's largest health insurance scheme and has more than 10,000 Jan Aushadhi Kendra, ensuring comprehensive healthcare access for its citizens. Gone are the days when people questioned a poor's ability to use phones and engage in online transactions. New India has empowered even a poor, uneducated street vendor to adopt fintech with such an ease, all thanks to the success of Digital India. India underwent survival mode initially with the opening of more than 50 crore Jandhan bank accounts. Society went under transformation and entered the aspirational stage when every pie of benefits got timely credited to their bank accounts through 314 schemes, increasing people's financial security, savings, investments, and leading a progressive life. Gradually, India's digital public infra sparked interests across the nations, so much so that Bill Gates recently admitted that no country has built a more comprehensive digital infrastructure than India. The World Bank too said that 47 years target met in just 6 years. DPI stands as an inspiration, with India leading in the digital payments with fastest fintech adoption rate in the world at 87%. Gone are the days when women risked their lives inhaling chulha smoke and waiting in long water queues. New India has empowered even the underprivileged women with home ownership, ensuring ease of living through tap water and LPG connections. India underwent survival mode initially with providing 10 crore gas connections, 13 crore tap water connections, and home ownership to 4 crore women. Society went under transformation and entered the aspirational stage when a staggering 30 lakh crore worth of loans were extended to women entrepreneurs, giving them financial freedom. When female employment rate witnessed a significant rise from 23% to an impressive 37%, and Nari Shakti Vandan Adhiniyam was passed after 27 long years. Gradually, India's internal evolution positioned the nation as a global influencer, inspiring other nations, when it prioritized women-led development as its primary agenda at the G20. Gone are the days when no bulletproof jackets were procured for our soldiers for years. New India has marked a milestone in indigenous production, be it shipbuilding, aircrafts, or naval submarines. India underwent survival mode initially with Make in India initiative and PLI scheme, reviving indigenous defense manufacturing at massive level. The defense sector aspired to maximize its defense manufacturing, and it was for the first time ever when it crossed rupees 1 lakh crore in financial year 23-24. India has also set up Asia's largest helicopter manufacturing facility at Tumkuru. With consistent efforts, India achieved the inspiring 23 times rise in defense exports to 16,000 crore, the highest ever. By the way, for a matter of fact, India now manufactures bulletproof jackets and exports to more than 100 countries. Gone are the days when imported mobiles were seen as a status symbol. New India is a place where tech giants are rushing to invest in India to set up their manufacturing bases. India underwent survival mode initially with massive investment through PLI scheme. With highest data penetration, cheapest data in the world, and optic fibers reaching the villages, India stood out as a digitally empowered nation in no time. Transitioning into the aspirational phase, India witnessed a remarkable 400% surge in exports of electronic goods, 200% increase in internet subscriptions. Today, India has claimed the title of world's second largest mobile producer. Not only this, India also had the fastest 5G rollout in the world. Emerging as a semiconductor hub, India is also becoming a magnet for tech giants like Apple, Samsung, Micron to establish manufacturing bases here. Gone are the days when India was among fragile five economies. India underwent survival mode initially with strategic initiatives such as Atmanirbhar Bharat, the PLI scheme spanning 14 sectors, push for startups, positioning India as a manufacturing hub. The stage was set for the self-reliant economic trajectory. Transitioning into the aspirational phase, India experienced a meteoric rise from the world's 10th largest to the 5th largest economy. Today, India is emerging as the fastest growing economy despite global uncertainties, and it's on its way to become the 3rd largest by 2028. Gone are the days when parents pushed students into conventional studies for mundane jobs. New India has capitalized on the entrepreneurial spirit and has begun an innovation revolution. All this was possible when government believed in the limitless potential of the youth. India underwent survival mode initially with the inception of Rs. 10,000 crore Fund of Funds for Startups in 2016. Startups received critical support through mentorship, tax benefits and easy exit mechanisms. Transitioning into the aspirational phase, India now proudly hosts more than 100 unicorns with a staggering 1.15 lakhs registered startups. And almost 50% of these startups come from Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities, signaling a democratization of entrepreneurial opportunities. India's startup story is an inspiring one, with becoming world's third largest startup ecosystem and registering a whopping 870% increase in patents granted since 2014, shaping innovation and technological advancements. Not only this, India was also ranked fourth globally in terms of fintech startup funding. The meteoric rise of India as an economic power has not only been a boon for its own people, but also for the world. In India's progress lies an array of scalable solutions to drive inclusive development around the world. If India can eradicate poverty, it can also save humanity through vaccine maitri. If it can empower its people digitally, it can also make UPI an inspiration for the world to replicate. If it can become the fastest growing economy, it can also bring the global south to the table. India's progress is not just its own story, it's a story of global good.